Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the last several lectures, we have seen that quadratic functions can be written in general form and vertex form. No matter in what form they are written, the graphs of quadratic functions are always parabolas. In general form, quadratic functions are written as ax squared plus bx plus c, where a determines the width and orientation of the parabola, and all three constants together determine the parabola's position. In vertex form, quadratic functions are written as a times x minus h squared plus k, where just like in general form, a determines the width and orientation of the parabola, but unlike general form, h and k are the horizontal and vertical coordinates of the parabola's vertex. Quadratic functions written in vertex form can be converted to general form and vice versa. The constant a is the same in both forms and doesn't change when converting from one form to the other. But we must calculate values for h and k when converting to vertex form, or b and c when converting to general form. So let's derive formulas to convert from either form to the other. To create a formula to convert vertex to general form, we will start with the vertex form and eliminate the parentheses by expanding x minus h squared, rewriting it as x minus h times x minus h. Then, using the FOIL method, we multiply the two binomials. Multiplying the first terms in each binomial gives us x squared. Then multiplying the outer terms gives us negative hx. Multiplying the inner terms, we once again get negative hx. And multiplying the last terms gives us h squared. We can then combine the two negative hx terms and distribute the a to the terms in parentheses. Now, if we compare this rearranged vertex form of the function to the general form, we see that the coefficients of x squared are identical, but the coefficients of x are different, and the constant terms are different. Since these two equations are just different descriptions of the same quadratic function, we can equate the coefficients of x in both equations and equate the constant terms in both equations. This gives us formulas that allow us to calculate the values for b and c in the general form, given the values of a, h, and k in the vertex form. Now, using the formulas we just created, we can also derive formulas to convert from the general form to the vertex form. To calculate h, we simply divide both sides of the first formula by negative 2a. And to derive the formula for k, we first replace h in the second formula with the right side of the formula for h, and eliminate the parentheses by squaring the numerator and denominator of this fraction. Then, multiplying by a, we can further simplify by writing a squared in the denominator as a times a and canceling the a in the numerator and one of the a's in the denominator. Finally, moving the term b squared over 4a to the opposite side of the equation, produces the formula for k, given known values for a, b, and c. We now have conversion formulas that allow us to calculate values for the constants h and k in the vertex form. Given the values of the constants a, b, and c in the general form. You might recognize the formula we just derived from the vertex's horizontal position, negative b over 2a, from the previous lecture, deriving the vertex form of a quadratic function. In that lecture, we saw that the vertex's x-coordinate is negative b over 2a, and by plugging that value for x back into the quadratic function, we can also calculate the vertex's vertical position. Although it is much easier to sketch the graph of a quadratic function written in vertex form, knowing where the function intersects the x-axis can also be useful when sketching its graph. But to do this, we must first learn how to solve quadratic equations. In the next lecture, we will explore the difference between quadratic functions and quadratic equations.